What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo. Yes, we are back. And I'm finally going to start working with MDT. I realized that I haven't touched MDT for such a long time. And I don't have an MDT server within my environment. So I'm going to start building it out with you guys. So let's get right into it. All right. So the first thing that I'm going to show you guys is the Windows server version that I am currently going to run MDT. So on the desktop, I'm going to right click on the start menu, click on run, and I'm going to type in WinVer and hit OK. So I'm going to install Windows ADK and also MDT 8456, let it rest in peace, because that is the last version that Microsoft did the hard cut on that utility. It's an amazing utility. I don't know why they stopped updating it, but I'm going to install it into server 2022, and this is the build. My server is also domain joined, so if I click on the start, go to server manager, and I go to local server, it's already within my domain. It has a static IP address and it's good to go. That's my environment. It's time for us to download and install Windows ADK. So open up your favorite browser. I install Google Chrome into this server and we need to go into this particular website. And within here, we're going to scroll down a little bit and we're going to locate the link that says download the Windows ADK. So we're going to click on that. Boom, it is done. The next link that we need to click on is download the Windows PE add-on for the Windows ADK. So click on that, boom, and it's done. These two setup files were dropped inside my downloads folder. So I'm going to open up my downloads folder. I'm going to select the ADK setup file. I'm going to right click on it and run it as an administrator. So by default, it is going to drop it inside the C drive. So I'm going to leave it as is. Click next. I'm going to say no here. Click next. We're going to accept the license and agreement. And I'm going to leave everything as the default. This is out of the box. These are all the features that it's going to install. So I'm going to leave it as is. Click install. Give it some time. Once it's done, it's going to give you this. So we're going to close it. We're going to select our ADK WinPE setup file. Right click on it, and then we're going to run it as an administrator. You're going to get this. It's going to drop in the C drive. I'm going to leave it as the default. Click next here. No here. Click next. Accept the license and terms. You only have one feature that's going to be installed. Click install. And it's going to start installing that feature. Once it's completed, you're going to get this. So we're going to close it. Close everything. Now, if you click on the start menu and you scroll down, you're going to see the Windows Kits folder. That's the new thing. That's everything Windows ADK centric inside that folder. So that installation is done. Now, the next thing that we need to do is download and install MDT 8456. So open up your favorite browser and we need to go into this particular website and then click on that big button that says download. You're going to get this nice little dialogue, and I'm going to download the 64-bit MSI file. We're going to click on download, downloaded, open up the downloads folder. Awesome. We're going to select our Microsoft Deployment Toolkit x64 file, right click on it, and we're going to select install. You're going to get the Microsoft Deployment Toolkit wizard. So we're going to click next here. Accept the license and terms, so give it a nice little check mark, and then click next. For the setup location, I'm gonna leave it as the default, so I'm not going to touch it, so I'm just going to click next here. Customer experience, I don't want to join, so click next, and install. It's going to install, give it some time, and once it's done, you're going to get this. Awesome, so click finish. Now, once you click finish, it is time for us to create our deployment share. So on the desktop, let's click on the start button. Let's locate deployment workbench. Click that. It's going to load the Snap-in console. Once it loads up, you're going to get this. We're going to select the deployment shares folder. We're going to right click on it and then pick new deployment share. Now the deployment share path by default is going to drop it inside the C drive, but I'm going to drop it into my D drive. That is a separate partition that I have. So I'm going to change it to D. Awesome. Click next. Share name, I'm going to leave it as is. So let's click next here. For the deployment share description, I'm definitely going to change it to the following. Click next. all these options, I'm going to disable them, uncheck them, because I'm actually going to do all this stuff within the custom settings INI section of the deployment. That's going to be a later on video. Again, I want to start fresh because I've heard like MDT 8456, when you're deploying Windows 11, there's a lot of problems. That's the reason why I'm trying to create the virtual machine back inside my environment. I've been doing a lot of SCCM. I really want to get into the MDT world again. So from here, let's click next. A nice little summary, click next. It's going to start doing its thing. And once it's completed, you're going to get this. So let's click finish. You're going to see your new deployment share. So if you open it up, you're going to see all the folders that we're going to be touching pretty soon. Not now, but later on. Now, we got a deployment share. What's next? I typically like to import an operating system, right? So operating system folder, I'm going to select it. But before doing that, because I'm running everything within a virtual machine, within my virtual machine environment, I make sure that I mounted the Windows 11 ISO inside my virtual machine, and that is the E drive. Let's head back inside the deployment workbench, and we're going to right click on the operating systems folder, and we're going to import an operating system. We're doing a full set source file, and we're going to click next here and source directory. So click on browse, and it is going to be the E drive. So the entire E drive, the root of the E drive. So click OK, click next here. Destination directory name, I'm going to leave it as the default, so click next. A nice little summary, click next, and it's going to start copying all that information inside that ISO into your deployment share. So give it some time. Once everything is done, you're going to get this. This is good. And then click on finish. Once you click finish, you're going to see within your operating system all the Windows 11 flavors inside that ISO. All right, so we just imported our operating system. What is the next step? The next step is creating a task sequence so we could actually deploy our operating system. So select that task sequence folder, right click on it, and then select new task sequence. You're going to get the task sequence wizard. So we're going to enter our ID. This is really up to you. And we're going to enter a task sequence name. This is what I entered. Once you enter all that information, click next. For the template, we're going to leave it as a default, a standard client task sequence. Okay, click next. Pick your flavor. I'm going to do a Windows 11 Enterprise. Once you pick your flavor, click next there. For the product key, I'm going to leave it as the default. Do not specify a product key at this time. I do have a KMS server within my environment, so it is going to get licensed. So click next there. For the operating system settings, I gave it a full name, organization, and a IE home page. And click next. Provide a local admin password and then confirm it. Make sure you remember it and then click next. You're going to get a nice little summary. So just click next and give it some time. It is going to complete. It's pretty quick. So click finish here. The next step, once you create your task sequence, well, I'm doing the task sequence for now, but I think the next steps would be the drivers and packages and all that stuff. But I'm going to do that a little later. But the next step is updating the deployment share. Well, that's what I did. So I'm going to select my deployment share, right click on it, and then pick update deployment share. You're going to get the update deployment share wizard. So click next, next. It's doing this thing, but I get this. This is one of the problems with the Windows 11 ADK. You're probably saying to yourself, how do you fix it? So by design, Windows 11 ADK, the latest version, is built this way. This is how Microsoft built it. I don't know why, but it is nuts. This is how you would fix it. You need to go inside this path. And within this path, you're going to see two folders. You're going to select the AMD64 and make a copy of this inside this folder, like I did, right? Once the copy is done, rename it to x86. If you investigate and look and read that error that was provided, it's actually looking for the x86 folder, but it's not there. This is by design. I don't know what Microsoft was doing, but hey, this is how you fix it. So once you make the changes, go back inside your deployment share, right click on it, update the deployment share, click next here, click next here. It's going to bypass all that stuff and it's going to start mounting the WinFile to make the changes within your deployment share. Once it's completed, you're going to get this, which is a good thing. It's always a good thing when you get this. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.